Hi everyone, oh, I miss you. Anyway, so I'll make this short. We're working out of a book called Cannery Row by John Steinbeck. John Steinbeck is the same guy that wrote Of Mice and Men, and many of you have already read that. You know, with George and Lenny. All right, well, there you're gonna see a lot of similarities. Anyway, it's easy to get online. Just type in Cannery Row, Steinbeck, PDF, it comes right up. So these are the experiences of John Steinbeck after he came back from World War II, where he was working as a war correspondent and where he saw many of the horrors of the concentration camps. And that is going to be very evident in a lot of these passages. There isn't much of a plot, but there is a lot of description and the characters are vivid in how they treat each other. So I'm referring to chapter 6. Can see my tablet and listen to how he describes the tide pools. But when the tide goes out, the little water world becomes quiet and lovely. The sea is very clear and the bottom becomes fantastic with hurrying, fighting, feeding, breeding animals. Crabs rush from frond to frond of the waving algae. Starfish squat over mussels and limpets, attach their million little suckers, and then slowly lift with incredible power until the prey is broken from the rock. And then the starfish stomach comes out and envelops its food. Orange and speckled and fluted nudibranchs slide gracefully over the rocks, their skirts waving like the dresses of Spanish dancers. And black eels poke their heads out of the crevices and wait for prey. The snapping shrimps with their trigger claws pop loudly. The lovely colored world is glassed over. Hermit crabs like frantic children scamper on the bottom sand. And now one, finding an empty shell he likes better than his own, creeps out, exposing his soft body. Where am I? Soft body. Oh, I lost my place here. The anemones expand like soft and brilliant flowers, inviting any tired and perplexed animal to lie down for a moment in their animals. And when some small crab or little tide pool Johnny accepts the green and purple invitation, the petals whip in, the stinging cells shoot tiny narcotic needles into the prey, and it grows weak and perhaps sleepy while the searing caustic digestive acids melt its body down. Then the creeping murderer, the octopus, steals out slowly, softly, moving like a gray mist, pretending now to be a bit of weed, now a rock, now a lump of decaying meat, while its evil goat eyes watch coldly. All right, so this shows a lot of movement. Have you ever been at a tide pool? Have you noticed where we are? We're at the beach today. So I've got my bucket, I've got my frisbee, and I've got my tide pool, and I've got Cannery Row. So Pacific Grove is where most of this takes place. And a lot of the characters in the book actually existed. So what I want you to do is to, in chapter 6, I know I put on Teams chapter 5, I was wrong. It's chapter 6. I hope you read the whole book. But if you don't read the whole book, start on chapter 6. It describes the movement of a tide pool. And yes, there are some great rhetorical strategies. There's imagery, diction, syntax, repetition, anything you want, it's there. So think of how John Steinbeck probably used this description of the tide pool to describe how people in a community rush around. Consider the quad at lunch. It's pretty crazy. Little pockets of people are here and there visiting with each other. And then think about the hallway in between classes. You have 6 minutes to get from the north to the south. You're in a rush, you're pushing aside, you're running because you need to stop and talk to your friends, you need to show someone something on your Instagram or your Snapchat, and you have to get to class on time. So, what is that like? So, I have some prompts for you. First of all, and this is for 10th grade, this comes from the 10th grade Common Core Standards 10.1, but 11th graders, AP Lang, you can certainly use this prompt as well. Argue for how the description of the tide pools compares to the action of the quad at lunch. Got it? I'll type it up on Teams. So I would give this 30 points if you can hit the third page. All right, any questions? Ask. Another prompt. Let me get my trusty prompts here. Now, this one is a little more complicated, 10th grade. If you want to hit it, you can, but this one really is very AP Lang-ish. How does Steinbeck use rhetorical strategies to create his argument that tide pools can be compared to the actions of humanity? So, AP Lang, if you want to write this, you need to show his main argument, which is that the tide pool is a community and can be compared to a community of humans. Imagery, personification, and the use of diction would be my choices, but certainly there is a lot of repetition that is very, actually, the repetition creates the imagery, because you could see the use of the suffix ing, the swirling, whirling, and that creates the action of the tide pool. Definitely use that as rhetorical strategy. Now, 10th graders, before all this craziness happened in our world, you were supposed to be working on monologues, and I did promise you a monologue, so now's your chance. Create a monologue that describes the action of walking down a hallway in between classes. As you're doing that, create a running metaphor that's kind of like the action of the tide pool. Compare the tide rushing in and out. You ever notice that when the bell rings, everyone rushes out of the classroom? That's kind of like the tide flowing in and out of the tide pool. You ever been to a tide pool? The water flows in and out, and there's a lot of action. You can see the little sea anemones moving around. All right, so that's a whole lot like walking in between classes, rushing out of the classroom and then rushing into another classroom. So turn that into a monologue and describe it as you're walking down. Oh, I can see my friend. Oh, there she is. Oh, I have to show her my Instagram. Oh, stop, please stop. Okay, so that could be like a monologue. I would say keep it appropriate. Keep it to about 1 minute. I would say that one is about 20 points extra credit. You can make it funny. Like I said, keep it appropriate. You can include your friends, but please practice social distancing or use a split screen. So let's go to another prompt. All right, the next one is going to take us to another section of Cannery Row. So hang on. And we need to go to chapter 15. All right, so move to chapter 15 with me.